Hello friends, continuing with the hair transplant education series, this video is going to talk about the differences between FUT and FUE, and this is going to be one of the most important videos of this hair transplant series. A lot of patients come to us saying that 9 out of 10 clinics have told them to do FUE, so and while I suggest FUT. So I try to make them understand the difference between FUT and FUE. So please watch this video right till the end and like and subscribe to this channel. Dear friends, thank you for watching this video. Please like this particular video and subscribe to my channel. This will give access to all the upcoming amazing videos that we are going to put up and also open up all the other videos that I have posted so far. A lot of clinics suggest FUE because FUE is much easier to do. We only need two people to do it. They need not be doctors. For a clinic, it is much easier to do, much cheaper to do, and you don't need a plastic surgeon to do FUE. Whereas for FUT, you need a proper qualified plastic surgeon to perform the procedure. The team required is much larger. Logistically, it's much more expensive. Therefore, clinics which have their own system, where they have their own plastic surgeon, where they have their own teams, are able to perform FUT, whereas others are not able to perform FUT. The scar is very, very thin in FUT. It is virtually invisible. FUE scars can actually be much more. So I have videos on YouTube as well as on Instagram where we are clearly able to show that FUE scars are much bigger, in fact, compared to FUT scars. People who have had extensive FUE, in fact, need to keep much longer hair in order to cover those thin, dense, low density areas. Whereas with FUT, they can easily manage with even this hair. Both the techniques require similar amount of healing. In fact, FUT heals up much faster. Then the pain is almost the same in both the conditions. So there's absolutely no difference. In white hair, we suggest the use of FUE because it's difficult to see the roots while we are doing this strip technique. Difficult to separate the roots because they are white. Curly hair, again, we suggest the strip technique because in FUE, there is a lot of damage to the curly hair. And when we are doing a very large session, mega session, we often combine the two techniques. One of the biggest problems of FUE is that a lot of doctors, when they want to do a large session, they go outside the permanent zone. So they may go in front, they may go above the permanent zone, they may go below the permanent zone, and that will lead to a loss of result after a few years. FUT is always done in the center of the permanent zone and the hair is always permanent. So we always recommend to do FUT, particularly if someone needs more than one session, then we always recommend to do FUT the first time. And in large sessions, it should always be a combination.